quantum circuit structure can vary, and when we look at the circuit, the orientation of gates and their order matters. So what happens to the matrix for a gate if it's flipped? So for example, let's take a CNOT gate and take the control and target and exchange them. So we have our normal orientation for our CNOT that we're quite familiar with versus the inverted orientation where we exchange the target and control. We have our CNOT symbol and the corresponding matrix. If we examine the input and outputs and see how the state evolves, we can see that we only have a change in the target's value when we have a control equal to one. So in these two bottom entries of our state evolution table, we see that our target changes value when our control has a value of one. So it causes the NOT operation to toggle on that target. In quantum circuits, we might not always see the CNOT gate in the in its standard orientation. So what happens if it's flipped? If we have a target on top and the control on bottom? We can do some analysis on our circuit and see what the corresponding input and output combinations are. So we have 0, 0, that's going to result in a 0, 0. Now remember, this first qubit is now the target and the second qubit is now the control. So 0, 1, that means we have a control going into a control value of 1. So that results in a flip of the target values. We have 1, 0. So 1 is the target, 0 is the control. That's going to result in a 1, 0 output from the gate. And then we have a 1, 1 that is going to cause the target to toggle and an output of 0, 1 to be generated. So how do we take those values and form the matrix? We've done this in class. So we just go ahead and see how the inputs and outputs are associated, and we fill in each column value with that. So we have 0, 0 corresponding to 0, 0, 0, 1 corresponding to 1, 1. So this is the vector for 1, 1, 1, 0 corresponding to 1, 0, and 1, 1 corresponding to 0, 1. So we have the 0, 1 vector here. As we can see, the inverted CNOT has a different matrix than the CNOT gate where the control is on top and the target is on bottom. So what about the control Z gate or the control phase flip gate? Does this gate show any difference in its matrix when we exchange the target and control? Let's find out. So we have our standard input output pairs, and we can see that only when we have an input of 1, 1 do we have a phase reflected at the output. So that makes our controlled Z matrix. Then we invert control Z. We can create that state table once again. So here, even though we have the target on top and the control on bottom, we can see that we still have the case that when 1 and 1 are input into the gate, that is going to be the only condition that causes phase to appear on the output. So if we generate the matrix for that, we end up getting the same control Z matrix, even though our target is on top this time. The inverted control Z matrix is the same. To summarize, just like order matters for combining gates in a quantum circuit, orientation is very important for multi-qubit operations. So this is something to keep in mind as we start to look at more complex circuit structures. The CNOT gate demonstrated the fact that the regular implementation where the control is on top and the target is on bottom demonstrated a different matrix and a different function from the implementation where the target is on top and the control is on bottom. The control phase gate or the control Z gate, however, was shown to be special in the fact that you could flip its orientation and that did not change the function associated with the transfer matrix.